pumps, compressors, etc., which obviously would be the backbone of our operations of every guest room for the most part as an AC unit.
If I may interject just a little, but wouldn't this be an incentive for more hotels and players in the industry to go green? Perhaps find alternative sources of energy and alternative methods of accomplishing some of what they do accomplish.
You won't find anybody who is more green than me in terms of my thought processes. Mm-hmm. We worked with the government a few years ago through the Hotel Association to bring Green Globe to Jamaica. Green Globe has a specific standard that is designed for the tourism sector.
Okay.
It looks at your consumption patterns. It basically it determines what you consume, what you consume, and how you can improve on it. We have quite a number of hotels in Jamaica that are now green to the extent that they can be green.
Okay.
The cost of the capital cost of becoming green,
yes,
is not cheap.
Very high. Yes.
It's very, very high. And in many instances, the payback is not in keeping with what you thought. Nonetheless, we pushed ahead. We pushed ahead, but what we found is consumption works well. Also retrofitting where you can from a light bulb to a pump, making sure that you're changing your equipment very often. Rather than reusing old technology, use new technology. That has helped us significantly. Now, working with your governments, working with your other partners, the people who sell you things, to get better technology to put into your product is far more beneficial than going completely solar. Yes, solar for heating. Wind, many of our hotels, by the way, are going into wind, but by the way, wind doesn't work everywhere.
I have seen some very still windmills on the journey here. So there are
two very large ones in particular, right, between here and outer.
That's important. Those are the ones I saw.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So we, for the most part, have been pursuing the green technology. And in fairness, many organizations have been coming and approaching us, trying as best as possible to sell us, but technology moves so quickly. Nonetheless, the best defense against electricity is consumption. However, when you're in an environment where what was promised by the Office of Utilities Regulation was a 4% increase to the commercial sector, you ended up with a 65% increase year on year. Somewhere in between the two distinctions is called chicken business, from a 4%
to
65% year on year consumption. If you take the organization I work for, I work for Sanders, we saw a 5% decrease in real consumption per kilowatt hour, and we saw a 65% increase in cost.
Well, I'll tell you, I know you, the Jamaican people will side with you on this.
Oh, absolutely, and I feel very strongly, mm-hmm, that it is the time has come for the government to break the back of the relationship between OUR and JPS, and more importantly, to break their contract, and whether they get into legal problems or not, they must figure it out.
Can't have one utility holding a certain ransom. I certainly agree with that. Okay, all inclusives. They also receive some flack for keeping visitors away from the many wonderful cultural, geographical, and historical facets of the island. So in effect, it is thought, mm-hmm, it is a mindset that they actually harm tourism more than they help it. Again, what would be your response to that?
Well, I tell you, it's clear that we have to do a far better job of information. Mm-hmm. Because all-inclusive did come out of a time when our security challenges was top of mind. In the 80s, when we had real challenges, mm-hmm, walls got higher, security got intensified. It has moved from being a security measure to being a concept that is desired, in fact, demanded. Mm-hmm. You can barely find a Caribbean product that is not seen as all-inclusive to be successful. If you, however, talk to the attraction sector which has grown by leaps and bounds in Jamaica, over 120 approved attractions in Jamaica, will tell you where their business comes from. You see the buses and the cars and the bikes going back and forth along the roadways and byways. Most of them are coming out of all inclusive. Yes, the argument will be, of course, the majority of your hotels are all inclusive, but it's actually not true. A third of the rooms in Jamaica are small hotels.
Okay.
A third, 10,000 of them. The majority of the large hotels are all inclusive, but then you still have the other European brand hotels operating. Mm-hmm. But the majority of those persons who are getting out, who are seeing Jamaica culture, flora and fauna, are in fact the all inclusive. We learned a lesson long ago. The all inclusive happens to be a more efficient way to travel. One, the client feels that their package is predictable. They know what it costs, your food, your beverage, etc. is taken care of.
Mm-hmm.
But two, we've also learned that the more people we can get out of the hotel on a daily basis is also good for business.
Okay.
Less food and beverage served. So we will encourage you
right.
to go and see our Jamaica office. And mm-hmm. Jamaica is probably the most phenomenal place in terms of variety, in terms of great sites
mm-hmm.
for people to go and enjoy themselves.
So it is mutually beneficial to
It is have. Absolutely mutually beneficial. I will say to you that more of us here in Jamaica need to experience the hotel sector.
Well,
combined
that,
as well as to go out and experience attractions to come across some of the visitors
that
who are in fact coming from those places.
That would lead me to a question that I have down on the list, but I'm just asking now.
Sure.
Are there plans in the works to attract more local visitors to our hotels?
Absolutely. And right now we're working with Jamaica Tourist Corporation with a program called Experience Jamaica. And I think it is unfortunate that we have to have a program called Experience Jamaica for two reasons. One on our side and two on the side of Jamaicans.
Okay.
You almost have to reach out and attract them. Those of us who have a few dollars in our pocket would easily see a plane ride to Orlando and beyond as a vacation destination. There's no problem with that. People want to experience new things. But Jamaica is not your first thought.
Yes.
The other thing is that Jamaicans travel in special windows. There are 10 vacation days, there are 10 holidays in Jamaica. And Jamaicans specifically want to travel over those days. Here's where we sometimes have a challenge. When you run high occupancies, which we all yearn for,
mm-hmm.
Jamaicans want to travel for 1 or 2 days. Now, that may be good on the face of it, but if you need high occupancy most of the time, when you can get a booking for somebody who's prepared to come for a week,
yes.
versus somebody who's prepared to come for 2 days, you're going to take those up. So to us, it's not a matter of where you come from. It's how is it going to affect my operation?
How about making it more enticing for them to come for a week?
It is extremely enticing. Most Jamaicans benefit from a 40% discount.
40% discount. I'm hearing that figure.
But I can tell you it has been around for a long time. In fact, in the 80s and in the 90s, it was mandated by the government for us to have what is called a local rate.
Mm.
Now, since the recession of 08, 09, etc., much of our discounts have now surpassed the discounts that would have been out there in terms of the 40% off. I mean, if you're discounting 50 and 60%, you're not going to be offering another 40% off. Obviously, you're going to be bare bones and giving the business away.
Mm-hmm.
But some of us have removed what is called the local rate now because the rates are just so attractive. When you go through the hotels,
yes.
you actually now see an increasing number of Jamaicans who are visiting us. Even travel agents in Jamaica are booking Jamaican hotels and are getting commissions off them, whereas in the past they never ever saw themselves as being a vehicle to book in Jamaican hotels, and they could always have done it, but they always thought about booking overseas.
Mm-hmm.
So I think both sides are getting to know each other a little bit better. You will see us advertising in the holiday periods. Unless somebody chooses a very strange day in the year for a honeymoon, most of them want to travel at Independence, they want to travel at Emancipation, they want to travel at Easter. It is how we move. I move that way, you move that way, it is how all of us move that way. But interestingly, some of those holidays coincides with your major market holidays as well. Hence, you end up with problems.
Would there be perhaps a responsibility on your part, you being the tourism industry, to perhaps advise Jamaicans that, you know what, sometimes these aren't necessarily the best days for you to travel. You can get great deals if you travel in between these periods.
Definitely. I mean, the responsibility must be on our side because obviously we're the ones on the receiving end of the business.
Mm-hmm.
But I think what you're finding now is that as the market is expanding, market conditions are taking over. With more hotels being in the fray, in the mix,
yes.
Rio may advertise today because they see where they're dipping there. You know, some of them can see 3 months down the road in terms of what is likely to happen.
Right.
I see them advertising today. I've seen them advertising multiple. Sandals will have ads running at different times. Supercops will do the same. Other independents will do the same. I am more concerned about us reading markets than having preferential arrangements. I think we've long passed the day when I need somebody to be pandering to me and you and me to you. I think if you are looking for a deal, the deal here in Jamaica must be as good as a deal somewhere else, and you must see the benefit in it. I honestly think that we can't have it both ways. We can't be saying we want preferential arrangement and all that. We're saying that you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It becomes very difficult and cumbersome for us to be trying to specifically deal with markets. We're in the business, all of us are in business to make money and be profitable, while at the same time the consumers who are keen, by the way, no matter where you come from, must demand price and quality when they want it. Not for me to come and tell you that you must travel when you don't want to travel.
Yes, that's much is true. I'm just saying perhaps it could be advised that, you know, these dates and times will work out better for them.
It won't always work out. They need to work those telephones, like, or get a travel agent to do it on their behalf, like everybody else would, because everybody wants to be in the grill for 18. Everybody wants to be notorious for the Easter holidays. I'm from Kingston. That's we move in packs. It's what we like to do. We enjoy it. We work with it. When the hotels are filled, they're filled.
Yes.
However, the persons who move out of that, out of those slots and go into the other periods, they may find themselves on President's Week. Jamaicans won't think of President's Week. They won't think of Thanksgiving. So I can't tell you which date, because the 10 dates that we have here may not coincide with another 10 days of another country's holidays, which happen to match in the tourism sector. So I would say to you, market forces, the consumers being the king of markets, must always dictate what we all do, which sometimes will force us to do a lot of work. But I would prefer that people don't see it as a them against us situation. If you want something, the price is right, go for it. We are always prepared to take you if you have the rooms and you're prepared to pay the rate, because at the end of the day we all have to select.
Okay. Can you state some, if any, plans that the industry may have in terms of marketing and improving? Not just marketing, but also improving Jamaica's product to the world.
Well, the good thing about Jamaica is that Jamaica, brand Jamaica, has a lot of equity. Brand Jamaica is powerful stuff, which we're, for the most part, using very badly.
I'm glad you admit that.
No, it is, and I'm talking collectively, Jamaica is using its brand badly.
Yes.
Tourism sells over here, manufacturing sells over here, sports sells in the middle over here, music is somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of talk and there's a lot of silos that have been created. Everybody's not talking that we need to get together.
Mm-hmm.
While we are all talking about it, not much is happening in the middle. And we must admit it, we must put that on the table. That aside,
yes.
The Jamaica Tourist Board has been voted the number one tourism bureau for this side of the world for the last 5 years running. With this
That's
limited,
a surprise.
I'm not surprised, I'll be honest with you, with its challenges, from a marketing point of view,
It
understands how to attract and trade. It gets into the Jamaica specialist programs, it gets into the travel agents' mind, why should you sell Jamaica, what's the differences in the different parts of Jamaica. They're up there, they're on the ground. But they're still smaller in size and value than the private sector, the hotels, the attraction sector. When you see people on the road, signed up with 120 business development managers across the world.
Wow.
Super Club has the same, Rio has the same, etc. These people, their only job is to be out there pitching product, pitching destinations, etc. at far greater value and cost than what we are used to focusing on in terms of the Jamaica Tourist Board spend.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, we've moved from the stage where we used to piggyback on the Jamaican Tourist Board, and Jamaican Tourist Board piggybacking on product, which is how it should be. Private sector must lead the way.